Hello anatomy friends, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we are going to start putting some names to the muscle compartments and groups in the upper limb. So not only are we going to name these muscle compartments, but we're going to locate them. So we're going to get an understanding of the general location of these groupings of muscles. And one of the more complex regions of the upper limb is the shoulder region. You will have muscles that are larger and span in terms of attachment sites, both the axial as well as the appendicular skeletons. And these are referred to as the axio-appendicular muscles. And we've discussed many of these in previous sessions, such as the trapezius, as well as the latissimus dorsi, and those pectoralis muscles. As we were dissecting the areas of their proximal attachment, so the superficial back or the anterior thorax. But their distal attachments will be on either the scapula or the humerus, thus affecting the actions of the pectoral girdle or shoulder joint. So important to consider these muscles again. There will also be shorter, but still very important muscles that proximally and distally attach within the shoulder region and affect the actions of the shoulder joint. So typically an attachment on the scapula and then on the humerus, and these are referred to as intrinsic shoulder muscles. And we'll discuss the specific muscles in upcoming sessions, but these will include the deltoid and then of course the rotator cuff. Moving distally from the shoulder into the arm, or scientifically referred to as the brachium region, we often use the term arm to mean the whole upper limb. However, that is not correct. The arm is this specific area, so where the humerus is located. And there are two major compartments here, and very fortunately, there is a similar organization in the forearm as well. Anterior compartments, which you can see here, are, as their name would suggest, anteriorly located. These compartments are often referred to as flexor compartments, as these muscles located here will play a role in flexion of, in this particular case, the elbow joint. We will discuss the actions in a bit more detail in upcoming learning objectives. The posterior compartment of the arm is located posteriorly, and the muscles located here will serve to extend primarily the elbow joint. And I keep saying primarily, as these muscles' most powerful movements will often affect the elbow joint, but these muscles may also affect other surrounding joints. But right now we are talking big picture, big generalizations. So a very similar organization in the forearm as what we saw in the arm, with an anterior as well as, or an anterior and flexor, we're adding in another action here, as well as a posterior extensor compartment. And again, we'll talk more about these specific actions and upcoming learning objectives. However, I do want to note that the forearm, this area, becomes more complex than what we had in the arm in two major ways. First, the forearm, there are considerably more muscles in the forearm than in the arm. Secondly, these muscles have more variability in terms of which joints they most forcefully affect. And these joints will include the various radial ulnar joints, the wrist joint, and joints of the hand. And these muscles are those examples of those long tendons. So we have the muscle bellies actually in the forearm, but the tendons will actually extend for many of these muscles all the way to the digits in many cases. Lastly, there are numerous compartments of the hand specifically, but we're going to focus on two prominent ones here in this big picture overview. These muscles, these hand muscles, with those forearm muscles whose tendons extend into the hand will affect the actions at the joints of the hand. Note, these do not affect these specific muscles that are located solely only within the hand do not affect the actions of the wrist joint. There is a fairly dominant thenar compartment of muscles, which is located on the thumb side, or that first digit, which is lateral. And then there is a hypothenar compartment of muscles on the pinky finger or fifth digit side, which is medially located when you're thinking in anatomical position. Remember, the palms face anteriorly in an anatomical position. There are certainly additional muscles in the hand, and these tend to be located deeper than those in the thenar and hypothenar compartments. And we aren't going to get in those specifics as they are not particularly foundational. Excellent. We have reached the summary slide, and I appreciate your time and attention here. Have a great rest of your day.